Here with me today is Chief Vanessa Wilson, VanessaWilson. She's going to give an update on an incident that happened at Hinckley High School. We got the call around noon today. Please be advised that information you're receiving now could change. We're at the very early stages of this investigation. So Chief Wilson.
Victims at local hospitals. We're trying to work out. Some of these individuals may be our suspects. Some of these individuals are victims. We did have an APS security officer heroically return fire and then also apply a tourniquet to one of the students that was hit. Our SROs quickly responded, and I want to thank the men and women of the Aurora Police Department that, as you can see, responded here quickly and were able to lock the school down and make sure that we had the students inside safely. I'm being told by APS that all students have been released now to their parents, so I want to thank you for that. I know you're going to ask me if this is related to our shooting on Monday. It is not confirmed at this moment. It's a possibility, and we will let you know as soon as we know. However, I don't want people to just make that assumption. We are, again, looking at every angle of this. I need the public's help. There was a fight that started in this parking lot, and then it went into a shooting. These are our kids that are shooting one another. We have disrespect and no concern for life whatsoever. I need the parents to get involved. I need you checking phones. I need you checking rooms. I need you checking cars, and make sure that they're taking these guns away from these kids. I had multiple shooters on this scene as well. We cannot do it alone, and I know, as you are, we are tired of this. Luckily, none of these injuries were being told are life-threatening, but again, the emotional scars, not only the people that were hit today, but the people that witnessed it are going to be lifelong. I have Superintendent Rico Munn here with me as well. He came out to show solidarity. The schools, once we have Rangeview School that is getting released within an hour, all APS schools will be on Thanksgiving break next week. I think I've told you everything. I'll open it up for questions of what we have so far.
Any arrests?
There are no arrests at this time. I know there is a social media video that's circulating of a white pickup truck. We have that pickup truck, so thank you for that. However, I must ask that anyone that has tips, anyone that has video, if your kids have video, please do not circulate it on social media. We need it either to the Aurora Police Department or best is Crime Stoppers. There will be a reward for this as well. At this point, it's up to $2,000, and we'll try to increase that as we can. Go ahead. People that have been shot are Hinckley students, and one is an APS Avenue student. We have not recovered any weapons that I know of, but like I said, we do have the white pickup truck that people identified some witnesses that were here.
Chief, can you go into a little more detail about the officer who did return fire?
I want to make it clear, it was an APS security officer, it was not an APD officer, so therefore we will be handling this investigation. Especially I'm leaving it to my major crimes unit that took the shooting on Monday to make sure if there's any linkages, we have all that information. But I do want to applaud his actions. He did a great job here today. Security officer, yes. I'm sorry? We have three people shot, and we think that possibly one of them may be one of our suspects. Again, we're still trying to sort out who's a victim and who's a suspect in this.
Possibly,
yes.
A parent wanted me to ask, are there any
Yes, so we have, all week long, we have had an increased presence at all the schools, and so we will continue that. Obviously, next week, we're out of school to give us a reprieve to try and get the people that are responsible for this in custody. But again, I need all information. I beg the public to please send us the information. I know that we're getting threats. We've had threats to Gateway, threats to Rangeview. We've sent officers there. I want credible tips to come to us. Absolutely. Anything that you hear, we need to know about it.
I know you mentioned that.
I'm sorry, what?
Did that increase police presence make a difference today? Response time possibly?
Well, the officer was here very quickly and helped the APS, and then, of course, officers had the school locked down within minutes.
I know you mentioned these guns are coming from somewhere. Do we know where they getting these guns? Is it black market? Is it online? Is it? Do we have any idea where these guns are coming from?
So I know that some social media platforms, is what I'm being told, some of these kids are able to go on and purchase weapons. So that's why I need parents to know what their kids are doing on their phones. And they need to know who they're hanging out with.
Was this school the target of any threats before this incident?
I'm not sure, ma'am, but we can follow up on that. I don't believe so.
What were those threats?
There was threats circulating out on social media that Granville and Rangeview were next. So we had officers respond. We do have video. We have surveillance video that we're going through. And please send us your video from your cell phones if you have it. Again, to Crime Stoppers or the Aurora Police Department. We have partial evidence, yes. Yes, sir.
There's multiple areas.
It's a very large area where the shooting, we had multiple shooters again.
And the white pickup truck, you say you found the pickup truck. Did you find the people that were driving the truck?
I can't release that yet, but we do have the pickup truck.
Listen, I don't want to put words into your mouth, but I can imagine you're frustrated at the time to talk about the incident. Can you walk me through just how you're feeling about this?
Well, obviously we were all shaken by what happened on Monday. Major crime detectives and other district detectives and officers have been working around the clock to solve that case. And then as we're driving to a peace march, we have another one. So I'm very frustrated. And I think everyone in this community should be very angry. And again, we love our kids, but we have to pay attention to what they're doing. We have multiple shooters. I can't give the exact number at this time. Anything else? Thank you so much.
So we'll try to put a news release out a little bit later today to kind of finalize some of this information. Again, very early and ongoing. Some of these details could change, and we're hoping to have some more answers later. Thank you.